I'm David Rose, and here's a look at some of our top cases this week on Washington's Most Wanted. You know, next month starts my 12th year of asking for your help to track down scumbags, dirtbags, lowlifes, creeps, and losers right here on Washington's Most Wanted. And every now and then, we get a true jackwagon. That's the best way to describe this purse thief in Ballard that Seattle police are really hoping you can identify. So watch in slow motion here as the crook makes his move at a Safeway store, grabbing a woman's purse from her grocery cart while she has her back turned to help a friend in a wheelchair get some milk. The victim realizes that purse is gone, and she takes off after him. But he is fast, putting down his basket of groceries and then bolting out the door. But that's where we get the best look at his face. So we're freezing here on the video so you can really look at his clothes, what he was wearing, the hat, the logo on his sweatshirt, and his profile. His chin kind of sticks forward. Detectives say the victim's purse had her driver's license, 4 debit credit cards, checks, $12, a bus pass, and a keychain inside.
There's an attempt to make a purchase at a nearby store. We have not been able to actually track that down yet, but somebody attempted to use her ID already.
Well, the theft happened in the middle of the day, just before 4:45 in the afternoon, at the Safeway on 15th Avenue Northwest in Ballard. This case is a good reminder to always make sure that you have your purse clipped into the cart if there's a strap available, or wear it across your body. Now, with jackwagons like this guy out there looking for easy prey, you cannot let your purse out of your sight for a second.
Mentally, the victim in this case is very distraught. You know, she loses her ID, credit cards, keys, all these kinds of things, everything that's in the purse. So does it make me mad? Absolutely. This guy's gotten away with it. Chances of him doing it again are very high.
So if you can identify this Ballard purse snatcher so Seattle police can put this jackwagon behind bars where he belongs, Crime Stoppers of Puget Sound will pay you a cash reward of up to $1,000. Just submit his name and any information you have through the P3 Tips app that you can download to your cell phone for free, or call 1-800-222-TIPS. Look closely at the photos behind me. This is the bug-eyed bandit. I want you to focus on this serial bank robber's eyes. You know, an ex-girlfriend, somebody in his family has to recognize this guy because the victims were pretty distracted by the huge gun he was armed with when he robbed a Wells Fargo in Kirkland last week. Surveillance video shows him wasting no time when he comes inside. He heads straight to an empty counter, but it's right next to one where a teller is helping a customer. And from the empty counter, he shouts demands at the tellers while he's pushing the revolver he was armed with through the swinging counter door, showing them he means business. He's armed. And from there, it's no secret this is an armed robbery. All the workers are on alert, and that customer scoots out of the way so the robber can swoop in to snatch up the cash that the teller's laying down.
The suspect most likely left in a vehicle and got out of the area pretty quickly. Made off with some money that was given to him from the teller at the bank. And so we're hoping by putting his face on Washington's Most Wanted that we can identify the suspect. It appears to be either a Middle Eastern or Hispanic male, somewhere between the ages of 18 to 30, somewhere in there. Looks to be average height, 5'6 to 5'11, average build, 150 to 180 maybe, and covered up his face with a mask that covers half his face. You can see his eyes. He's got very round, dark brown eyes that are very distinctive. And we're hoping by somebody seeing that, they may be able to recognize him.
Well, detectives say he also robbed a bank in Everett back in June because those eyes were a dead giveaway.
Similar bank robbery took place up at the Silver Lake Key Bank in Everett. And in those photos, you can see very similar looking male, dressed almost exactly the way he was on October 1st. Very similar MO as far as how he came into the bank, what he said, what he demanded from the tellers, and how he left. And in those photos, he's also wearing a mask covering half his face. And once again, you can see his eyes and see the distinctive facial features that he has, and they look to be very similar. We believe it to be the same male suspect. You do see the makings of a tattoo on the front of his neck. The tattoo, you can't establish what it is or what the insignia or what it looks like, but you can see that he does have a tattoo on his neck. And so based off the photos and the tattoo, we're hoping somebody can identify him.
So if you can tell Kirkland and Everett police the name of this bug-eyed bandit before he hits a third time, use the P3 Tips app on your cell phone, submit that information to Crime Stoppers of Puget Sound, or you can always call the hotline. It's anonymous, and you will get a cash reward of up to $1,000 if your information leads to his arrest. Cops call it a quick change scam. It's like a criminal magic trick that takes a ton of deception and distraction. And Snohomish County Sheriff's detectives say this guy pulled it off on some unsuspecting cashiers at the Walmart in Marysville twice on the same day on August 31st. So watch this sped up surveillance video that shows all the cash chaos as the suspect confuses the clerk over the course of a few minutes. There's bills flipping and flopping everywhere. He even comes around the corner at one point to spy on her till. He's chatting up the clerk the whole time, keeping her calm and preoccupied.
Essentially what he did was purchase an item for $2. He handed her $2, and when she gave him his change, he mixed in some extra bills and handed it back, asking her to recount it. He distracted her multiple times, doing this over and over, mixing in additional bills, and was able to scam the store for hundreds of dollars. He looks like he's practiced this. He knew what he was doing, and he did it twice in the same store on the same day. We absolutely want him off the streets. He's victimizing these stores, these cashiers. It's very sad, and it's very manipulative.
Detectives say these small mom-and-pop type stores and convenience marts are targets of the scam. They've got some good advice for cashiers.
When you get a large bill, leave it on top of the till when you're giving the change. Also, if someone seems to be distracting you or trying to get you off topic while you're counting the change back, just go ahead and slow down, be cautious, and know, count it out loud when you're giving it back. Counting out loud can help. Another thing is, if you don't feel confident, go ahead and close the register, stop the transaction, and call for your manager.
So if this guy walks into your store, call 911. If you know his name, submit that information to Crime Stoppers of Puget Sound through the P3 Tips app or the hotline 1-800-222-TIPS. It's anonymous, and they're offering a cash reward of up to $1,000 if you can identify this quick change scam suspect. When you go to work, so do thieves breaking into your home. Most residential burglaries happen during the day because crooks know the house is empty. And even though one victim in Port Orchard has a surveillance camera, it didn't stop this low-life dirtbag from stealing a safe filled with $34,000 in cash, silver coins, and important personal documents. Kitsap County Sheriff's detectives say they used these surveillance images to identify the suspect as 42-year-old Jeremy LaRose. Deputies say on August 6th, he waited for the homeowners on Westbrook Drive Southwest to leave. Then he came out of the woods, broke into the house, and as you can clearly see here, hauled out the safe. Deputies say he went back inside and stole a bunch of other stuff. Then he loaded it all into a Kubota utility vehicle that belonged to the victims. Then he drove that to the end of the driveway where he dropped off the stolen stuff before returning the vehicle. Detectives say LaRose pawned some of the stolen items in Bremerton just a week after the burglary. We'll now take a look at this booking photo from Snohomish County that shows him clean shaven. While they were investigating the home burglary, detectives learned on August 19th, LaRose had been arrested in Snohomish County for a burglary to a storage unit. Detectives recovered a backpack that contained the Port Orchard victim's Social Security card and a birth certificate. He was released from jail before Kitsap County prosecutors could charge him with residential burglary, theft first degree, and possession of stolen property. They've issued a $50,000 warrant for his arrest. And for those of you around Paulsbo, keep a sharp lookout for him.
We believe that Mr. LaRose is living in a residence in North Kitsap, and we also believe that the individuals who cohabitate in that house with him are providing excuses and cover for his presence there. Eventually, we will arrest Mr. LaRose. So we're looking for the public's assistance in trying to determine where he might be when he's not in the house, if you see him out and about in the community. For those who are engaged in covering for him, there is a possibility that a rendering criminal assistance charge could be in effect here.
Jeremy LaRose is 6 feet tall, 200 pounds. He's got blue eyes and brown hair. He almost always has a scruffy beard, but he was clean shaven last month and he'd cut his hair. If you spot him, call 911. If you can tell Kitsap County Sheriff's deputies where to find him, Crime Stoppers of Puget Sound will pay you a cash reward of up to $1,000. Call the hotline or use the P3 Tips app on your cell phone. This next fugitive has piled on a whole stack of warrants, and they're all for the same crime: violation of the Uniform Controlled Substances Act, dealing crack cocaine. A Seattle Police narcotics unit is asking for your help to find Dariot Abaga. Here's the thing. He's been on deferred prosecution in Seattle Municipal Court, given drug court after he was charged with two counts of hit and run, reckless driving, and DUI. And as part of that process, Abaga is not allowed to possess illegal drugs or commit any new crimes. But on September 15th, he was arrested in the sinking ship garage in Pioneer Square after an officer say they spotted him filling up baggies with crack rocks. He was booked for possession with intent to sell, but now he's out and he has not shown up to court. In the charging documents filed with the court, law enforcement objected to his release, saying he needs to be sentenced as he hasn't learned his lesson. Drug dealers are violent predators that need to be held accountable.
We've got six warrants totaling $100,000 on this guy. He's in the wind. We don't know where he's at. He continues to use. He continues to sell. This is a guy we want to get off the street. So they have asked us specifically to ask you, viewing the show, take a good look at this guy. We don't think he's run off anywhere. He's around the Seattle area. Somebody knows his location.
And that is the information that Seattle police need. So if you can tell the narcotics unit where to find Dariot Abaga, Crime Stoppers will pay you a cash reward of up to $1,000. Abaga's criminal history includes malicious harassment, illegal drugs, and DUI. He's 39 years old, 5 feet 10 inches tall, 195 pounds. If you spot him, call 911. If you know where he stays or you can tell officers where to find him, submit that information to Crime Stoppers through the P3 Tips app or call the hotline at 1-800-222-TIPS. That's a look at some of the cases that police need your help to solve this weekend. So join us for the rest on Washington's Most Wanted at 11:30 tonight on Q13 Fox, Saturday night at 10 on Joe TV, and 10:30 on Fox stations in Spokane, Yakima, and the Tri-Cities. And with your help and the partnership with Crime Stoppers, we can make sure these criminals have nowhere left to hide.